For example, you have a bunch of scripts, and sometimes they all need access to the same information or nodes, but they will do different things with it, so the class functionality cannot be used. You can declare the variable separately inside each script, or you can use singletons to store these variables for you and just call them each time you'll need them. Now, what is a singleton? The singleton is a concept that restricts the number of instances of a class to one single instance. It is useful when exactly one object is needed to coordinate actions across the project. Simply put, this is the one and only source of truth in your game. To better understand this concept, let me give you some examples from my game. In my game, I sometimes control the color of the sprite's shaders or the color of the sprite's modulation in scripts. Why would I declare the colors that I want to use each time for each script if I have a determined color palette and I can just use a singleton to store this data for me? Here I change the color of the outline of a sprite to be red, and this red is stored in the gameinfo.gd singleton. And since the gameinfo is the sole source of truth in my game, if I'd want to change the color palette, I would just need to change the colors in one place and not worry about going through each script that uses them. Now, the cool thing about singletons in Godot is that it is actually a node being created at the root of your game, so you have access to all the nodes in your tree. So if you have some nodes that you need access to from different scripts, you can store them as variables in singleton and call them when you need them. Here I have a voice line server, which is a node in my game that plays voice lines, making sure that only one voice line is playing. So when I need to play any voice line, be it from the enemy or the player or any other script, I just ask the variable stored in the game for singleton to play the voice lines instead of declaring it in each script. But make sure to identify the path to the nodes you need correctly. It is easy to do since all the singletons will load first, and only then the first node of your game will load in. So the position of your main scene will always be the root node's children count minus 1. Creating a singleton in Godot is simple. Create a new script, make sure that it extends the class that you need. If you are not sure, just extend the node 2D for the 2D games. That way you will probably have access to all the functions you'd need. You can easily change the class later here. Write what you need in the singleton script. You can just store some constants and variables for your game or have some functions that can be called from any other script. Go to the AutoLoad tab of the project settings. Choose a script and make sure that the singleton option is enabled. It is useful to have this concept in mind from the start. In my case, I didn't know what a singleton is before recently, so I had to go through each script and see what nodes, constants, variables and functions I call repeatedly from various scripts and store them in my game for singleton to make the scripts at least somewhat readable. And this process is still ongoing while I continue to make progress on my game. If you found this video useful, please leave a like, subscribe for more content about Godot and game development, leave a comment and other YouTube stuff. See ya!